The Raptors take on the Sixers, 7 o'clock Eastern start time. Philadelphia's -3, totals 210. Real quick, guys, if you find yourself enjoying this video here today, please feel free to give it a thumbs up by smashing that like button. And if you want to connect with me on a daily basis, please feel free to hit that subscribe button right now as well and join the Brock Page family. We upload videos here on YouTube darn near every single day. And most important, guys, we went 4-2 in our 6 premium sports picks on brockpage.com yesterday. That's going to put us at 6-0 with a push in our last 7 extra daily picks on that website. And if you want to access today's extra daily pick, it's only going to cost you just $2.99. We also improved to 8-0 in our last 8 college basketball tier package picks on that website dating back to last season. And the good news is we have another college basketball tier package pick going off here this evening. We currently have over 850 members who are signed up and active on that site. And if you want to see which one of these free YouTube picks on this video that I'm actually betting on personally, there's only one way to do that, and that's to sign up for a membership on my website at brockpage.com. And when it comes to this ball game here in South Philly, the Sixers are currently on a 2-game losing streak, and they're still going to work here without Joel Embiid. He's on the health and protocol list, vaccinated, but still got the vid and still sitting out a lot of games. That's really crazy how that works. But anyway, Thibault and Joe are still out. Harris and Curry are questionable. And even with a healthy squad, the Sixers have failed to cover in 4 of 7 contests at the Wells Fargo Center this season. They're currently dead last in the NBA in offensive rebounding, bottom 10 in second quarter scoring. Meanwhile, defensively, as good as they've been, the Sixers are currently in the bottom 3 in second quarter points allowed as well. They're taking on a Raptors club who leads the NBA in fewest points allowed on the road. The Raptors are giving up just 97 points a game when traveling, and they're leading the NBA in fewest third quarter points allowed on the road. Now, Gary Trent Jr. is averaging just about 3 steals a game defensively. Now, 15 total points a night for Trent. And speaking of scoring, OG Anunoby is averaging over 19.5 points a night, along with 5 boards to assists. Now, injury-wise, Siakam's still out. Watanabe is questionable when it comes to the total in this one. 4 out of Toronto's last 5 road games fell under the number. Meanwhile, the Sixers are 5-2 the under at the Wells Fargo Center, 8-4 to the under for the entire season. I'm going to lean toward Toronto +3, under 210. Next game, Pacers, Jazz, 9 o'clock Eastern tip-off. Utah's -9, totals 216.5. The Jazz are undefeated at home this season, 3-1 against the spread in those home victories. Utah's in the top 5 in scoring, top 3 in offensive rebounding. Donovan Mitchell scoring over 25.5 points a game, 4 rebounds, 5 assists for Don. Meanwhile, Rudy Gobert is getting nearly 16 rebounds a game, along with 14 points. The Jazz also lead the NBA in defensive rebounding per contest. They're holding their opponents to just 101 points a game at the Vivint Arena. They're taking on a Pacer team who lost 6 out of their last 9. As a matter of fact, the Pacers are just 1-6 straight up on the road this season. They're letting their opponents make 40% of their 3-pointers against them when they travel. Now, injury-wise, Warren and Jackson are still out. Caris LeVert is questionable when it comes to the number in this one. 5 out of the Pacers' last 10 meetings with Utah did get over the number. Meanwhile, the Jazz saw 2 out of their last 4 at home get over the line themselves. I'm going to lean toward Utah -9, over 216.5. Next and final matchup, Heat versus the Clippers, 10:30 Eastern start time. LA's -3, totals 212.5. The Clippers have successfully covered the point spread in their last 4 straight. As a matter of fact, LA currently finds themselves on a 5-game winning streak, and they're allowing only 101 points a game at the Staples Center. Paul George is averaging nearly 3 steals a game defensively, 26 points per contest, and 8 boards for PG. Meanwhile, Reggie Jackson's averaging over 17.5 points a night, along with 3 boards, 4.5 assists. LA's holding their opponents to just 30% shooting from beyond the arc on their home court. They're taking on a Miami squad who's in the second of a back-to-back here tonight. They've lost three out of their last four. They gave up 120 points and a loss to the Lakers last night. Now, Tucker, Morris, Butler, Hero, and Struess, they're all listed as questionable for Miami. The Heat's currently in the bottom five in second quarter points allowed on the road. When it comes to the scoring in this one, Miami's last three straight got over the number. 5-1 of the over in their last six. Meanwhile, three out of the Clippers' last four got over the total themselves. I'm going to lean toward the LA Clippers minus three over 212.5. And with that, guys, now it's time for our quick pick recap. Powered to you by my website at brockpage.com, where we are 6-0 with a push in our last seven extra daily picks. I'm going to go ahead and lean toward Toronto plus three under 210. Utah minus nine over 216.5. Before I give you my next and final free pick for the video, one final reminder that not only are we 6-0 with a push in our last seven extra daily picks on brockpage.com, we're also 8-0 in our last eight college basketball tier package picks on that very same website. I'm going to lean toward the LA Clippers minus three over 212.5. And with that, guys, now it's time for our shout-out of the day. And that's going to go to Fontella's Furniture, who said the other day, thanks for the picks. All right, guys, that's going to do it for me. Don't forget to check me out on brockpage.com. Now, if you guys do end up getting a membership here today on that website, just keep in mind you're going to get billed the day you sign up and then the first of every month following that. So if you do end up getting a membership here today on that website, you are going to get access to those picks all the way through the end of November. Although I do tell folks in every single video, the earlier in the month you sign up, the better. But most importantly, guys, somebody's car alarm's going off. And that's really loud. Okay, they turned it off. Anyway, guys, gotta thank you for joining me right here on YouTube. As you've noticed this week, with the start of college basketball, we've got a lot of content that we're pushing out each and every day. And as a matter of fact, normally I upload my college football and NFL picks for the entire week, you know, earlier in the week. We just have so much going on that, you know, we're just kind of like banging out daily content right now. So I'm doing my best to get on that stuff. But man, we got a lot of stuff going on right now. You guys are going to be the big winner because there's going to be so much content that I'm going to be producing here for the next probably 6 months now. So certainly good times, but just be patient with me. You're going to get those college football free picks. You're going to get those NFL free picks eventually. But just bear with me, man. It takes a long time to research and do all the work here behind the scenes. But anyway, I know you guys understand. You guys know what goes into it. But anyway, guys, got to thank you for joining me right here on YouTube. Really hope you enjoyed all this great free content, all this great free information. And with that said, guys, happy Thursday to you. Best of luck to you. And I look forward to seeing you later on today on my website at brockpage.com.